Yes, we can. So listen, today the mother in me is still raging. Today the mother in me is still unwilling to be quiet. It's still unwilling to be nice. It's still unwilling to be pretty and be shut up. No. What happened in that elevator was the result of thousands and thousands of women, survivors, and survivors of all genders who are doing something incredibly dangerous and incredibly generous. What we are doing with our stories is weaving a fabric that can be a mirror for this country, allowing our pain to be in service of transformation. We have an opportunity right now, in this moment. Senator Flake has an opportunity, Senator Murkowski has an opportunity, Senator Collins has an opportunity, Senator Manchin, Democrat, but we're watching, has an opportunity to say, I will not continue to affirm the culture that believes and values men above women. That's really it. That's what it comes down to. They can in this moment model a different behavior. They can say, I may not have all the facts, I certainly wasn't there, I'm not sure exactly that the story is coherent, but what I do know is that I have heard through this process of storytelling, of coming out of the shadows, of coming out of the pain, I have heard that violence against women is at the core of who we are today. I have heard that through the stories, maybe with some holes in the facts. Maybe because when you're traumatized, you can't actually remember everything. Because when it's happening to you, what you remember is not the date or the address. You don't remember the details of the room. You remember what it felt like. And you know, that's why survivors, when we hear Dr. Ford's story, we know. We know. We know. And they know. And they know. And they're scared because they know they have seen it happen before. They know they maybe have been in those rooms. They know they may have more in common with Brett Kavanaugh than they're willing to say. So listen. But this moment is not the moment of one story or two stories. The story is a story of us, of so many people that are organizing, that are doing things that are incredibly scary for us. Telling our story is incredibly scary. Protesting is sometimes scary. Taking direct action is sometimes scary. And we're doing it. We're overcoming our fear and our pain and our rage to give this country an opportunity to be different. That's what this nomination is about. That's what it is. So let me tell you, Jeff Flake, he knows. He knows. He knows. Manchin knows. Collins knows. Murkowski knows. All of them know. The FBI investigation is important because the country deserves a process that's rigorous, that's responsible. But what the country really needs is a democracy that works for us. That's what we need. So what we're doing today with our voices, with our stories, with our protests, with our sittings, what we're doing today is breathing life into a democracy. So that democracy is about us, and it's not owned by those very few that have so much money. That's what we're doing.